Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. This is the part 1 of the 3rd week current affairs, and I have covered current affairs from 14th of August to 20th of August. Important thing to understand is that from now on I bifurcate the video because it is very difficult to cover 185 questions in one video and without compromising the length. Therefore, this video will be around only 30 minutes and it will cover around 90 questions. If you are preparing for any exam like SSC, CGL, CHSL, LDC, Bank PO or Clerk or UPSC, we also have a very dedicated test series for UPSC, and you need to dial this number, any of the three, or you can go to our website for more details. Which bank has become the first private sector bank to provide Aadhaar enrollment and updation facility? It has become the first private sector bank to do so, and for that they opened their first branch in Chennai. First center, such center in Chennai. So this bank is headquartered at Karur, which is in Tamil Nadu, and this bank's chairman is Mr. B. Swaminathan. B. Swaminathan is the chairman of this bank. This bank is Karur Vyasya Bank. Which country has recently signed 3 agreements with China in the energy sector? In the energy sector, this country is Nepal, and Nepal's capital is Kathmandu. President is Bidya Devi Bhandari. Prime Minister is Sher Bahadur Deoba. China's president is Xi Jinping and capital is Beijing. Currency is Yuan. Important thing to understand is China and India are having a face-off at Dokalam. And it will be interesting to see how this face-off continues now. And China will host its annual congress also very soon. And there will be communist congress also very soon. So it will be very interesting to see. Also, China is also hosting this year's BRICS summit in September in a place called Xiamen. This is also very important. And China has also invested in a port in Sri Lanka. It has bought the port, which is called Hampantota in Sri Lanka. And in Pakistan, there is a port which they have invested in, which is called Gwadar. So all these, this is very important data. One more important question which they can ask you is, there is a company called PetroChina. PetroChina has got the contract from India to ship the US shale oil from America to India. When was Organ Donation Day observed across the globe? First organ donation took place in 1954 and it was a kidney donation. So to mark that day, we celebrate it on August the 13th. Dr. Bhakti Yadav passed away. She was the first woman doctor of which state? She was the first MBBS doctor of Madhya Pradesh. She was awarded this year only Padma Shri in 2017 April. So the answer is Madhya Pradesh. Union Cabinet has given its approval for a new policy for which of the four? This is for Metro Rail, and making private public partnership mandatory for availing central assistance for new metro projects. That is, central government will not approve any metro project if it is not built in a PPP model. Important thing to understand is that although it is called Metro Railways, it does not come under Ministry of Railways. It comes under Ministry of Urban Development. Our Minister for Urban Development is Narendra Singh Tomar, who is also our Rural Development Minister. Earlier, Urban Development Minister was Venkaiah Naidu, but Venkaiah Naidu became Vice President of India. How much penalty has been imposed on Reliance Industries Limited and its partners for producing less than the targeted natural gas from K5-D6 fields? They produce less gas than desired, than they agreed to, and therefore a fine of $264 million has been put on Reliance Industries Limited. So remember this, and this is the Eastern Offshore Field K5 to D6. So total penalty now, which is the form of disallowing recovery of cost incurred for missing the target. Basically, this penalty has been put. This will compensate for the loss of revenue because of non-completion of target. Sohail Mahmood, he took charge as the High Commissioner of which country to India? High Commissioner word we use in Commonwealth countries, and in a non-Commonwealth country we use the word Ambassador. So earlier it was again Pakistan's Abdul Basit. He has replaced Abdul Basit and now it is Sohail Mahmood of Pakistan. He is Pakistan's Ambassador or High Commissioner to India. Scientists in which country have developed a blood test that can identify tiny amounts of cancer-specific DNA? Cancer-specific DNA now can be identified. This research was done in America, USA. And they will be able to basically distinguish between DNA that is shed from tumors and the other DNA, altered DNA that is present in the blood, thereby facilitating early diagnosis of cancer. Which of the following companies has signed a $500 million loan agreement with Asian Development Bank. Asian Development Bank is headquartered in Manila. Manila is the capital of Philippines. Philippines president is Rodrigo Duterte. Asian Development Bank, remember that it has given a $500 million loan for power grid project. Power grid project. And Asian Development Bank's president is Mr. Takehiko Nakao. Mr. Takehiko Nakao, he is from Japan. Japan has the highest share in this bank. India is the fourth highest shareholder after Japan, US and China. India has registered a growth of how much percent in foreign tourist arrival in July 2017 compared to the corresponding period last year? Corresponding period means July 2016. Compared to that, it has shown a growth of 7.4%. 7.4%. And percentage share of foreign tourist arrivals in India during July was highest from Bangladesh. That is, India received highest tourists from Bangladesh, almost 20%, and then USA around 16%. Union Cabinet recently approved signing of a MOU with Sweden in the field of what? So it's a Scandinavian country, rich country. Capital is Stockholm. Sweden's capital is Stockholm. So we have signed a MOU for intellectual property rights. Intellectual property rights, IPR. This will enable India to exchange experience in the innovation and IPR ecosystem. Now, one more thing regarding Sweden, they can ask you, what is the currency of Sweden? It is a Euro country, but Euro is not the currency. So its currency is Krona. Actor Shanmuga Sundaram, he passed away. He was associated with which film industry? He was associated with Tamil film industry. Now my first question for you today. What is the name of Tamil film industry? Like we say Bollywood, etc. What is Tamil film industry called? Write down in comments. Central government has approved a fund of how much amount under the definitive 5-year action program for the upgradation of the Coast Guard, Indian Coast Guard, which is a paramilitary force. For that, how much fund will be there? It's a 5-year action program for upgrading the Indian Coast Guard because India has a long coastline. India's longest coastline is Gujarat, followed by Andhra Pradesh. Total amount is 31,748 crore rupees. Where was the 6th edition of India-Turkmenistan Intergovernmental Commission held recently? So this is basically a commission for mutual cooperation between India and Turkmenistan. The capital of Turkmenistan is Asgabat, and currency is Turkmenistan Manat. So this is basically to establish a transit corridor between Iran, Oman and Turkmenistan. So it's a big project and this meeting took place in New Delhi. Which cricketer became the second Indian batsman to complete 4,000 one-day runs in successful run chases? Successful run chases. He scored 4,000 one-day runs. And he has become the second Indian batsman to complete so. His name is Virat Kohli. Virat Kohli. And overall, he has become the third batsman after Sachin Tendulkar and Ricky Ponting. But they are asking Indian batsman. So he's second Indian batsman after Sachin Tendulkar. And he completed it in his latest innings. And he also, in the latest ranking released by ICC, he tops the list of one-day batsmen. So that is also something to look forward to. And India won, India won the cricket series against Sri Lanka 3-0 overseas. Which festival was recently celebrated in Union Territory of Puducherry? The Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry is Kiran Bedi, and Chief Minister of Puducherry is V. Narayanaswamy. Although a union territory never has a chief minister, this does not apply to two. Yani two exceptions are there. That means Delhi and Puducherry, because they have legislative assembly and chief minister. And otherwise, any union territory is directly controlled by the center via a lieutenant governor. So which festival I'm talking about? It is called Feth the Puducherry. Feth the Puducherry. Feth means festival. Festival. So it is held in association with the South Zone Culture Center of Tamil Nadu. Reserve Bank of India recently introduced a new banknote of which denomination in the Mahatma Gandhi series? And you can see here, this important thing which you can see here is Hampi. This chariot is Hampi. Hampi, it is in Karnataka and it is a World Heritage Site. And the numbers, they will also increase from left to right. We have made a separate video also on this note. It is rupees 50 note. Now, Reserve Bank of India recently announced that it is starting to publish rupees 200 note also. And rupees 500 notes in the new inset letter. Earlier, after demonetization, the 500 rupee note that was published by the Reserve Bank of India had inset letter E. Now, the new ones will have inset letter A. and the color of this note, you can see it is called fluorescent blue. Fluorescent blue. Who has been appointed as the chief financial officer of Tata Motors? Who is the chairman of Tata Motor? It is N. Chandrasekharan, who is the chairman of Tata Sons, the entire group, as well as Tata Motors. So the person is P.B. Balaji. He has been appointed as chief financial officer. He was earlier the chief financial officer of Hindustan Unilever. Who has been appointed as the managing director and CEO of Karur Vyasya Bank? Managing director and CEO. So I told you Mr. B. Swaminathan, he is the chairman. I am talking about managing director and chief executive officer. His name is P.R. Shashadri. He replaced Mr. Venkatraman. An agreement between the oil companies and EESL was recently signed. Which energy efficient appliance will now be sold in fuel retail outlets of public sector oil marketing companies? It is LED bulb, LED tube light, ceiling fan, or all of the above? The answer is all of the above. This is to enhance the participation in the Ujala scheme, in which we have plans to replace the old incandescent bulbs with the new LED bulbs, and also to replace old bulbs, tube lights, and old fans, and to replace them with more energy efficient power devices. And he is our power minister. His name is Piyush Goyal, and he is Dharmender Pradhan, oil and gas minister. How many Indian origin individuals have been listed in the annual ranking of the most influential young people, Fortune's 2017 40 under 40? How many Indians are there? Total there are 5 Indians. So remember, and Irish Prime Minister Leo Varadkar, he is in top 5 also. Prime Minister of Ireland is less than 40 years of age. And also President of France is also less than 40 years of age. You know his name, Emmanuel Macron. Emmanuel Macron, his party name is En Marche. He is less than 40 years of age. So he was number 1 in this list. And other important people were Divya Nag, Rishi Shah, Shraddha Agarwal, Leela Jana. So total there were 5 Indians in 40 under 40. Energy Efficiency Services Limited, EESL, is going to procure how many electric sedans in order to increase the popularity of electronic vehicles in India? And some of the companies which manufacture electronic cars are like Tesla, for example. So please note that Tesla last year, it's a company of Elon Musk. And this company, last year it was awarded the most innovative company of the world. But this year it has been replaced by Salesforce.com. Salesforce.com is now the most innovative company of the world. So total cars they will procure is 10,000. 10,000 cars. And managing director of EESL is Mr. Saurabh Kumar. Saurabh Kumar. Now only one Indian company manufactures electric sedan, which is Mahindra. It is called Mahindra Verito, who has been appointed by Russia as its new ambassador to India. This is a very important post because Russia is our all-time all-weather friend. So his name is Nikolay Kudashev. And this happened because the ex-Russian ambassador to India, he died on duty. His name was Alexander Kadakin. Russian president is this fellow Vladimir Putin, who is the most powerful person in the world for last 3 or 4 times in a row. Russia's capital is Moscow. Currency is ruble. Which asteroid is going to safely pass by Earth on September 1 at a distance of about 4.5 million miles? So this will be very, very near to Earth. Asteroid means something that is like a star but not a star. That is asteroid. This asteroid is called Florence. And remember, NASA's telescope called Spitzer Space Telescope and Near Earth Object Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer, which is called NEOWISE mission, indicate that asteroid Florence will pass very near to Earth. So Spitzer Space Telescope and NEOWISE mission. And NASA also launched another mission called Juno for Jupiter and Cassini for Saturn. Union Cabinet has recently approved setting up of a non-lapsable fund. Non-lapsable fund for what? Primary education, secondary or higher education? Education is a subject under the HRD Ministry, Human Resource Development, headed by Prakash Javadekar. And this is for secondary and higher education. So the answer is 2 and 3. This will be a non-lapsable fund. Also note that they have kept a name for it, which is called MUSK, Musk, which is Madhyamik and Uchchatar Siksha Kosh. माध्यमिक एंड उच्चतर. माध्यमिक मीन्स सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन, उच्चतर मीन्स हायर एजुकेशन, शिक्षा मीन्स एजुकेशन एंड कोश मीन्स लाइक अ फंड. सो माध्यमिक एंड उच्चतर शिक्षा कोश. हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द चेयरमैन एंड मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर ऑफ हिंदुस्तान कॉपर लिमिटेड HCL. सो इट इज मिस्टर संतोष शर्मा. मिस्टर संतोष शर्मा. यूनियन कैबिनेट रिसेंटली गेव इट्स अप्रूवल टू नबार्ड फॉर रेजिंग एक्स्ट्रा बजटरी रिसोर्सेज ऑफ अप टू हाउ मच अमाउंट फॉर द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ AIBP स्कीम विच इज कॉल्ड एक्सेलरेटेड इरीगेशन बेनिफिट स्कीम. एंड नबार्ड वॉज एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन 1982 एंड नबार्ड चेयरमैन इज मिस्टर हर्ष कुमार भानवाला. मिस्टर भानवाला इज द चेयरमैन ऑफ नबार्ड. इट वॉज एस्टेब्लिश इन 1982. टोटल अमाउंट इज 9020 करोड़ रुपीज अंडर द AIBP इम्प्लीमेंटेशन. विच अफ्रीकन कंट्री रिलीज सिल्वर कॉइन ऑन लॉर्ड कृष्णा ऑन जन्माष्टमी ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ जन्माष्टमी. दिस कंट्री इज छैड. CHAD. कैपिटल इज एन जामेना इज द कैपिटल एंड करेंसी इज सेंट्रल अफ्रीकन फ्रैंक CFA franc. दिस कंट्री इज छैड. ऑल्सो देर इज अनदर कंट्री दैट वॉज इन न्यूज विच इज कॉल्ड जिबूटी विच इज इन हॉर्न ऑफ अफ्रीका. कैपिटल इज जिबूटी सिटी. इन जिबूटी चाइना हैज एस्टेब्लिश्ड अ मिलिट्री बेस. सो दीज टू अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज वर इन न्यूज. स्टीफन वुल्ड्रिज हु पास्ड अवे रिसेंटली ही वॉज एसोसिएटेड विद विच स्पोर्ट. ही वन द गोल्ड मेडल फॉर ऑस्ट्रेलिया इन द 2004 एथेंस ओलंपिक्स. इन सेम ओलंपिक्स इन 2004 एथेंस इंडिया वन द सिल्वर मेडल बाय राज्यवर्धन सिंह राठौर हु इज नाउ अ मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट. सो ही वॉज एसोसिएटेड विद साइक्लिंग. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. And he represented Australia. And 2004 Olympics were held in Athens. However, the very first Olympics in 1896 were also held in Athens, capital of Greece. Which cab aggregator has launched a business-to-business model, B2B model? B2B model is launched by Uber. And it is called Uber for Business. Uber for Business. Which company recently launched an education cell designed for universities and polytechnics, which is called RoboWiz? RoboWiz has been launched by TAL Manufacturing, Tal Manufacturing. And this company, the same company, Tal Manufacturing, has earlier launched India's first robot, which is called Bravo. Bravo. And by the way, Tal Manufacturing is owned by Tata Motors. Which of the following has become the top commodity in terms of exports from India? India was the highest exporter of buffalo meat, beef, but now it has been replaced by Basmati rice. So for 3 years in a row, beef was the number one export. Now basmati rice is the number one export. And in July, India's exports increased by 3.9%. Which company was presented the Silver Stevie Award in the best new product or service of the year, software platform as a service category at the 14th annual International Business Awards 2017? This company is called CSS Corporation and it is artificial intelligence company. Mr. Manish Tandon is the CEO of this company. Nestle India. Nestle is a fast moving consumer good company which manufactures Maggi and chocolates and various other products. Nestle tea, Nestle coffee, etc. It has tied up with which company to launch a nutritious range of Maggi noodles. This company is Amazon India. Amazon India chairman if Jeff Bezos. Scientists have recently named a 100-million-year-old damselfly, after which renowned naturalist. He also had produced a lot of documentaries. His name is David Attenborough. So, and this damselfly, you can see here, it was discovered in Myanmar. Second World Congress of Optometry is going to be held where? World Congress of Optometry. So you know what is optometry, related to your eyes. When the eyes are checked for a particular number, that branch is optometry to be precise. It will take place in Hyderabad, capital of Telangana. It will be from September 11 to September 13. Which country has announced a ban on import of iron ore, iron, lead and coal from North Korea? The tensions between these two countries are also at an all-time high. They were supposed to be estranged allies, but now they are more like a foes than friends. This country is China. North Korea's capital is Pyongyang. And it's pronounced as Pyongyang. North Korea's dictator is Kim Jong-un. and China's president is Xi Jinping, and relations between China and North Korea are estranged because of USA. India recently celebrated its which Independence Day? So, and our Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment, Thavar Chand Gehlot, he inaugurated the Inclusive Independence Day celebrations, which were organized by National Trust. India celebrated 71st Independence Day. And Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi, he announced to invest 1,000 crore rupees to transform 20 Indian universities into world-class universities. There was a two-day Chief Electoral Officers Conference which was recently held in which Indian city? It was held in New Delhi. And Chief Election Commissioner now is Mr. A.K. Jyoti. It is not Mr. Naseem Ahmed Zaidi now, it is Mr. A.K. Jyoti. And Election Commissioner is O.P. Rawat. There are two Election Commissioners, one of them is O.P. Rawat, he attended the conference. Indian Army is going to procure how many Boeing made Apache attack helicopters in a deal worth $655 million from USA, because Boeing is a company of USA. There are other important manufacturers, like we have Dassault. Dassault is a company of France. Then there is Airbus. Airbus is also a company of France. Total how many? We will buy six very high precision, very powerful Apache helicopters. Which player won the bronze medal in the women's skit at the 7th Asian Championship shotgun in Astana, capital of Kazakhstan? She has become the first Indian to win a medal in women's skit at the top level. So her name is Maheshwari Chauhan. But remember two more names, Rashmi Rathaur and Sania Sheikh. They won the silver medal in the team event. Which Indian girl has created a record by becoming the youngest person to climb Mount Stok Kangri? See, Stok Kangri is the highest peak in Ladakh. So the name of the girl is Kamya Karthikeyan. And the peak is 6,153 meter high. With which country is India going to hold a mega war game called Indra, involving their army, navy and air force? So it will be a military exercise between India and Russia. Very, very important exercise called Indra. With America, we have Yudh Abhyas. And with France, we have Garuna. And we have Shakti. India's first railway disaster management village. Railways disaster management village is going to come up on the outskirts of which city? We have had too many railway disasters. Recent one, very recent one also took place and took lives of a lot of people. It was in Meerut and it will be built in Bengaluru. It will be completed by December 2018. Railways has also made a loss of 33,000 crore rupees and railway minister is Suresh Prabhu. In Bengaluru, if they ask where, it is in the village of Hejala. And it will be built at a cost of 44 crore rupees. It will have situations like trains falling into river and coaches catching fire. They will be replicated here so that there is more disaster preparedness. So mock rescue operations will be conducted in this village. Where has the largest volcanic region on earth with nearly 100 volcano recently been found? Largest volcanic region on earth. It has been found in Antarctica. Antarctica. And it was below the surface of ice. 2 kilometers below the surface of ice. So it was very difficult. But it was found by researchers from the University of Edinburgh. And University of Edinburgh is in Scotland. Because Edinburgh is the capital of Scotland. Scotland is a part of United Kingdom. Researchers from which university have shown that they can successfully grow a preterm lamb within an artificial womb? This research was done by Tohoku University and University of Western Australia. So the answer is 1 and 4. How many medals did India win at the 7th World Dwarf Games, which were held in Toronto? Toronto, it is in Canada. Capital of Canada is Ottawa. And Canada's Prime Minister is Justin Trudeau. It is in North America, North American continent. So Indian Dwarf contingent went all the way to Toronto and they won 37 medals. 15 gold medal, 10 silver medal, 12 bronze medal. Total there were 21 members from India. And remember the name of two players. One is Joby Matthew. Joby Matthew won 6 medals including 2 gold medals. And Arunacham Nalini won 5 medals including 1 gold medal. So remember the name of two players. Joby Matthew and Arunacham Nalini. Joe Bologna. He passed away. He was associated with which field? He was an actor and a screenwriter. So the answer is films. Which country is going to conduct world's largest student learning survey? world's largest. And wherever you see world, you know, these words like world's largest, it will be in populous countries like India and China. The answer is India. And HRD Ministry's National Assessment Survey will be conducted. Sample size is 30 lakh students. So this will be conducted for students of class 3rd, 5th and 8th on November 13. Which country topped the medals tally at the recently concluded IAAF World Championships in London, capital of England? Country which came number 1 was America. It won 30 medals. And this was the mascot of the games. Mascot, it is a hedgehog. It is called Hero the Hedgehog. Hero the Hedgehog. Remember, for the para athletics, the mascot was Wisby the Bee. See, there were two separate mascots. One was for para athletes, one was for non-para athletes. For non-para athletes, it was Hero the Hedgehog. And for para athletes, it was Wisby. W-H-I-Z-B-E-E. Wisby the Bee. Second country was Kenya. Kenya won 11 medals. And third was South Africa. South Africa was third. India did not win medals, but it created personal records, like national records. So remember one person, his name is Davinder Kang. Davinder Kang, he became the first Indian to qualify for the men's javelin throw world championships. And Usain Bolt retired. So remember this also. Which bank recently adopted 50 villages as a part of its newly launched corporate social responsibility initiative? This is called SBI Gram Seva. Gram Seva means service of villages. So it is SBI, State Bank of India, and chairman is Arundhati Bhattacharya. Which country is going to build world largest single tower solar thermal tower power plant? It will be the world's largest single tower solar thermal power plant. This country is Australia. By the way, Australia recently became 35th member of International Solar Alliance, which was initiated by France and India at the COP21 conference. And this will be completed by 2020. It will be 150 megawatt. It will have 150 megawatt capacity. Also note that largest solar thermal installation in the world is currently in California, in USA. Ministry of Electronics and IT has issued directions to various internet majors to remove the links to which online suicide game. All the articles, all the download links, apps, etc. Remove all the links related to, it is called Blue Whale. It is called Blue Whale game because it is believed that blue whales, they come to the shore for committing suicide. That is, they come outside the water whenever they want to commit suicide. Google, Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, Microsoft and Yahoo. And this game was created by a 22-year-old. His name is Philip Budekin. Philip Budekin. It has total of 50 tasks. And the last task is to commit suicide. Who has been appointed as Earthport's new India head? Earthport's new India head is Mr. Sandeep Gupta. It is a UK-based company which runs a network for cross-border payment. As per the government, extreme weather events are annually costing India what amount? Extreme weather, like floods, like for example, we saw that in India right now, there are severe floods. Severe floods in, for example, Assam, in Bihar, and there is havoc everywhere basically. So total amount is $10 billion. Floods, droughts, whichever are there due to extreme weather. And it is projected to impact agriculture productivity with increasing severity from 2020 to the end of the century. Means the weather phenomena, the climate change will cost us more and more till the end of century. Which Bollywood actress has been appointed as a member to the newly constituted CBFC board, Central Board of Film Certification, CBFC. And earlier its chairman was Pralaj Nihilani. He has been replaced with Prashun Joshi. She is an actress. Vidya Balan is the answer. Other members are like Vani Tripathi, Ramesh Patange. There are a lot of members, you don't need to know the name, but just remember chairman is Prasoon Joshi, who has topped the world's highest paid female athlete 2017 ranking by Forbes. She is legendary Serena Williams. She plays tennis. She is from United States of America. And she is also the only female in the world's 100 highest paid athletes list. So this is really a statement, Serena Williams. Who has been appointed as the executive director of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India? Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India is headed by Mr. Sahu, and executive director is Mamta Suri. Which state government has announced not to observe a holiday on Gandhi Jayanti in the state-run university? All the public sector university in the state will not have a holiday on 2nd of October. So this is Rajasthan. Rajasthan has listed only 24 holidays for the academic year 2017-18. Which of the following is the 57th tectonic plate which is discovered by the scientists at the Rice University? It is nearly first time in 10 years that a tectonic plate has been discovered. This has been done. Its name is Malpelo. Malpelo. It has been discovered in the eastern Pacific Ocean off the coast of Ecuador. S. Paul passed away. He was a renowned what? So he was a very renowned photographer. Photographer. He was the first Indian to be profiled by the British Journal of Photography in 1967. And he was also the first Indian to win the Nikon International Photo Contest in 1971. Which of the following banks, headquartered at Kumbakonam in Tamil Nadu, has introduced the option of an instant credit card for free for its net banking customers? Option of instant credit card. This bank is City Union Bank. City Union Bank. And its chairman and managing director is N. Kamakodi. N. Kamakodi. Who has been appointed as the chief of Sri Lanka's Navy? Indian Navy chief is Sunil Lamba, who had taken over from Rovin Dhawan, if you remember. Sri Lanka's Navy chief is Travis Sinia. He is important because he is there first from the Tamil community since 1972. NGT, National Green Tribunal, has directed all the states to maintain a minimum environmental flow of what percent of the average lean season course in the rivers? What is the percentage of the average lean season course in the rivers that has to be maintained as a minimum environmental flow? It is 15 to 20%. 15 to 20%. And what does this mean? Environmental flow. It defines the quantity, timing, and quality of water flow required to sustain freshwater and estuary ecosystem besides human livelihood. And National Green Tribunal chairperson is Justice Swatantra Kumar. National Green Tribunal also banned manja, which is the kite flying thread which is coated with glass or heavy metal powder. Who won the men's single event at the Rogers Cup? Men's single event. It was won by Alexander Zverev. He became the first person to beat Roger Federer in a Masters 1000 or Slam event in 2017. Roger Federer this year is almost unbeaten. Roger Federer won two Grand Slams this year. One was the Australian Open, in which he beat Rafael Nadal in the final, and one was Wimbledon, in which he beat Mario Cilic in the final. Which boat won the 65th Nehru Trophy boat race at the Punamada Lake in Alappuzha in Kerala? Which boat won? Name of the boat is Snake Boat, which is called Gabriel Sundan. It is called the Snake Boat. And around 20 snake boats known as Chandanavalam in local parlance, they took part in the race. Kerala Chief Minister is Pinarayi Vijayan. He inaugurated the boat race. Mani Mahesh Yatra, which is currently going on, is a pilgrimage trek of which state? Mani Mahesh Yatra. It is in Himachal Pradesh. And pilgrims who visit Mani Mahesh to worship God Shiva and Goddess Parvati. Mani Mahesh Lake is situated at a height of 14,000 feet in Bharmaur area in Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh Chief Minister is Virbhadra Singh from Congress. As per a new study, which planetary system could be more than twice as old as our own solar system? Solar system, you know, has 8 planets and along with the sun. So which planetary system can be twice as big as solar system? It is called TRAPPIST-1. TRAPPIST-1. It was published in Astrophysical Journal, and our solar system was built around 4.5 billion years ago. And this particular TRAPPIST-1 is 40 light years away from our solar system. Department of Expenditure, it has roped in Energy Efficiency Savers Limited to retrofit energy efficient appliances in all the government premises across India. EESL aims to bring in investment of how much amount by 2020 for doing the same? This investment will be 1000 crore, and this will be for 10,000 large government buildings. Remember that. And EESL is the implementation agency for the buildings energy efficiency program, which was launched in May 2017. Who launched Bharat Ke Veer portal's live Twitter wall on the occasion of Independence Day? It was launched by Rajnath Singh, who is the Minister for Home Affairs. So our Home Minister is Rajnath Singh. So it was launched by Rajnath Singh. And also remember, Minister of State for Home is Hansraj Gangaram Ahir and Kiran Rijiju. Kiran Rijiju. This portal is for online donation to the families of the martyrs. Central government is working on a GIS-enabled database of land for assisting the industry. The database is being developed by which organization? DIPP, Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, BISAG, or National E-Governance Division, it is being done by all of the above. It will have details of around 3,000 industrial parks and clusters, as well as area-wise availability of agriculture, horticulture, crops, etc. SpaceX and NASA have launched a space-borne computer to the International Space Station. The supercomputer has been manufactured by which company? It has been manufactured by HP, Hewlett-Packard, HP company. And SpaceX has a rocket which is called Falcon 9. Remember the name Falcon 9. NASA is headquartered in Washington, D.C. Which of the following companies has launched PlanYourGoal.com? PlanYourGoal.com has been launched by ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund. Who has been awarded the Healthcare Personality of the Year award by Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, FICCI, at the 9th Healthcare Excellence Awards? So which person is this? This person is Dr. Nand Kumar Jairam. Also not another doctor, Dr. Arvind Lal. He has been awarded the Lifetime Achievement Award. Lifetime Achievement Award. US recently listed which terrorist organization or group as a counter-designated group? It is the Hizbul Mujahideen. And US had named the group leader Syed Salahuddin, also called Muhammad Yusuf Shah, as a specially global terrorist earlier on. So the answer is Hizbul Mujahideen. Who has been appointed as the interim managing director and CEO of Infosys post the resignation of Vishal Sikka? Vishal Sikka had a huge spat with one of the founders, Narayana Murthy, of Infosys, and he has been replaced with UB Praveen Rao. He is the interim managing director and CEO of Infosys. Center has approved the closure of a corporation involved in developing and managing forestry plantations in which state? This is Andaman and Nicobar Island, and it will be called, it was called Andaman and Nicobar Islands Forest and Plantation Development Corporation Limited. So remember this. This would be done by infusing funds of 125 crore rupees. It was set up in 1977. Andaman and Nicobar capital is Port Blair. It is a union territory. It also has very important two volcanoes. One is called Barren Island, and there is an active volcano also on Andaman Nicobar, and the highest peak is Saddle Peak. There is a Saddle Peak. And there is a national park also, Saddle Peak National Park. So Andaman and Nicobar, it is in the Bay of Bengal. National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority has recently announced price cap on what? There will be a price cap now on the knee implants. Knee implants. And therefore the prices has been slashed by 59% to 69%. Like cobalt, chromium, knee implant, etc. So this will help the poorest of the poor. Which bank has been conferred the best performance award for 2015-16 and 2016-17 by NABARD for its work in the field of credit linking joint liability groups? This bank has been awarded for the best performance award for two successive years. This bank is Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank. Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank. And you should remember the name of the chairman also. Chairman is S. Ravindran. S. Ravindran. India is going to establish a Chief Executive Officer Forum, CEO Forum, with which country to promote trade? This country's economy is also doing well. The currency's capital is Mexico City and currency is peso. It is Mexico. Mexico is a country from North America. It is a neighbor of United States of America. As per National Highway Authority of India Chairman Deepak Kumar, all the lanes of all 371 National Highway Authority of India toll plaza in the country will become fast tag enabled effective from which date? This date is October 1st, 2017. All the toll will have fast tag for smooth implementation of the roadways. And NHAI also launched two mobile apps. One is called My FastTag and second is called FastTag Partner. These are the two mobile apps launched by NHAI, National Highway Authority of India. Which bank recently ventured into social media by opening its official pages in social networking sites? This bank is the Bank of Karnataka. Karnataka Bank. Karnataka Bank, Mr. M.S. Mahabaleshwar is the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer. Karnataka Bank. Religious Freedom Bill 2017 and Land Acquisition 2013 Amendment Bill were recently passed by which state assembly? The Legislative Assembly of which state? This state is Jharkhand, and both the bills, since they have been passed by the Legislative Assembly, will now be passed to the Governor Draupadi Murmu for the final signature. So this state is Jharkhand. Jharkhand CM is Raghubar Das. Which of the following has recently approved the Reliance Communication and Aircel merger? Arcom Aircel merger. Who has approved it? It is NCLT which has approved it. And it overruled the telecom department's objection that the Supreme Court had restrained Aircel from selling and trading 2G spectrum allotted to it in 2006. So therefore now the merger has got a green light. Which space agency has launched TDRS-M satellite, which would aid astronauts in communication with Earth. TDRS-M, which space agency has done it? It is NASA, American Space Agency, National Aeronautical Space Agency. ISRO is Indian Space Agency, headquartered in Bengaluru. Chairman is S. Kiran Kumar. JAXA is Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency of Japan. And Chinese National Space Agency, which is CNSA, is of China. Reserve Bank of India has recently made Aadhaar mandatory for subsidized which type of loans? It has done it so for farm loans. Farm loans. Union Textile Minister Smriti Irani recently inaugurated a garment unit facility in which state? This has been done near Ranchi in Jharkhand. And she also inaugurated a second groundbreaking ceremony at Jamshedpur for laying foundation stone of 70 new companies. So remember, and also remember one thing, that Smriti Irani, the textile ministry, is the second largest employment provider in India after agriculture. And recently they organized a mega textile fair in Gandhinagar, capital of Gujarat. DONER Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh, this is for development of northeastern region, announced to set up a northeastern cultural and information center in which city? This will be established in New Delhi and it will be completed within 1 to 2 years at a cost of around 50 crore rupees. Rajiv Gandhi National Aviation University, India's first aviation university, is going to be inaugurated in which place? It will be in Uttar Pradesh. And where in Uttar Pradesh? It will be in Rai Bareli in Fursat Ganj. And who is the Vice Chancellor of this university? His name is Air Vice Marshal, retired Nalin Tandon. So these were the multiple choice question, part 1 only. It has around 90 questions, 90 more needs to be covered. They will be covered in the part 2, and that part is coming to you very soon in English language. Thanks for watching.